Welcome. It's fall here in Western North Carolina. The leaves are dropping, and pumpkins are available for the first time this year. It's a very exciting time for us because this wonderful orange squash creates so many versatile recipes. So you stay with us because we're going to teach you how to use this pumpkin in all kinds of delicious recipes. The first thing we need to do is we need to cut our pumpkin. So let's start by turning it over on its side. And I want you to take a nice sharp chef's knife and just simply go around the pumpkin about one third of the way up off the bottom and score it all the way around, just like this. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the bottom of this pumpkin and it's going to become actually our very first recipe. Now, as you can see, there's lots of beautiful seeds, and we're going to be talking about those seeds in just a minute because they're going to be our second recipe. So let's take the seeds out of this part of our pumpkin, just like this, very, very simple, very, very easy. And now inside of here, what we want to do is we simply want to take some butter, just like this, about a quarter cup. We want to take a third of a cup of sugar-free maple syrup, just like this. Drop it right inside of that pumpkin, just like that. And then we want to take some fresh nutmeg. Nutmeg is a wonderful spice. We want to just take some fresh nutmeg and grind it right on top of our pumpkin. And what we're going to do with this is we're going to take this portion of our pumpkin, the bottom pumpkin, and we're going to put it on a cookie sheet in a 350 degree oven, and we're going to bake it off for about 45 minutes. This will replace on your Thanksgiving table your sweet potato and your butternut squash. It's a terrific way of having a wonderful low-carb squash with your Thanksgiving dinner, or anytime you can get a fresh pumpkin. So let me just drop this into a 350 degree oven. The next thing we want to do is we want to continue removing the seeds from this beautiful pumpkin, just like this. Not hard to do. Just reach right in there with your hands and just kind of pull them out. And if you're gentle, you can get most of the seeds out without getting any of the pumpkin hair inside of the squash, you know, which is nothing more than the innards of the pumpkin. Okay, we've now removed all of the seeds out of our pumpkin. Now we want to rinse them. So just put some water in your bowl and simply rinse your seeds. You're trying to get off the little bits of pumpkin that are on your seeds. It's not hard to do. It just takes a couple seconds. Then I want you to take a cookie sheet. Put a little bit of melted butter on top of your cookie sheet. I've lined mine with some aluminum foil. Spread your butter around, just like this. Very simple to do. Kids love pumpkin seeds. And in fact, I love pumpkin seeds because they're a very low-carb treat. Now we're just going to take our pumpkin seeds, we're going to dump them on this cookie sheet, strain the water out of them, right in this bowl, just like this. See, there's a bit of that pumpkin meat in there. We'll just take that right out of there. It just takes a second. Here we go. Dump our seeds right on top of our cookie sheet, just like this. Very simple to do. And now what we want to do is we want to give those seeds just a little bit of salt. So we'll spread them around on our cookie sheet so that they're not laid on top of one another, just like this. There you go, nice and simple. Don't you love pumpkin seeds? They're crunchy. Now you can do lots of things with these seeds. If you wanted to, you could sweeten them up a little bit with some xylitol or some stevia, which are wonderful sugar-free sweeteners. Me, I just like a little butter and a little salt. So now we'll take and salt them up a bit, just like this. Be careful, not too heavy in the salt. Just enough to give them a little coating. And now these two will go into that same oven that the bottom of our pumpkin is in right now, roasting. And we'll roast these for about 25 minutes at 350 degrees. And what we want to do with this part of the pumpkin is we're going to cut it up into chunks and we're going to put it in boiling water. And now what we want to do is we want to steam that pumpkin meat inside of that boiling water for about 30 minutes. And then we'll peel the pumpkin right off the shell. Okay, welcome back. So our pumpkin is boiled. Our pumpkin is roasted, and our pumpkin seeds are roasted. Let's take a look. We took our seeds, they were inside of the oven for 25 minutes, and then we stirred them around with a spatula. Another 15 minutes, took them out and plated them. Let's take a look at our roasted pumpkin. Absolutely turned out fabulous. 45 minutes in the oven, then we took it out, we basted all that beautiful butter and maple syrup around it, and put it back in for an additional 45 minutes. Let's go ahead and serve a piece of that. I've already cut one chunk out, just like a pie slice. We'll plate it right up like this. We'll put a little extra nutmeg on top because nutmeg's just a beautiful spice when it comes to pumpkin. And we'll serve that as our squash dish, as a side dish on our Thanksgiving dinner. You could have even kept the entire top of the pumpkin if you wanted to have a cover for your squash. Now finally, we boiled our pumpkin meat for 30 minutes in boiling water, then we shut the heat off, and we left it sitting in the water for an additional 20 minutes. Then we took it out, we strained it, and put it here to cool. Now our next job is going to be to take all of that pumpkin meat off of the shell, and then we're going to mash the pumpkin meat, and we're going to use it for our pumpkin pies and our pumpkin bread recipes. So that's easy enough to do. We'll just take one of our pieces of pumpkin out. It's nice and soft and it's cool now. And we'll just go along the skin with a sharp knife, just like this, and it'll come right off. And just toss it in your pot, just like this. While we take a break, I'm gonna go ahead and finish this pumpkin meat for you. We'll get it all in this bowl, and when we come back, we'll mash it up. Okay, welcome back. I've taken and I've mashed a bunch of our pumpkin just using a good old-fashioned steel masher. And then I've taken 3 cups of that pumpkin meat and I've put it over here in this measuring cup. And what we're gonna make now is we're gonna make a pumpkin pie. I love pumpkin pie. So there's 3 cups of mashed pumpkin meat here and I've got 1 1/3 cup of heavy cream. So we're gonna put our cream right in with our pumpkin meat, just like this. Just kind of let that settle in, mix it up just a little bit, and then we'll transfer that over into our food processor. There we go. Put that right in like that. Okay, this is going to be an easy pie. Okay, the next thing we're going to add to that is we're going to add 3 eggs. We're going to add 1/2 cup of xylitol. Xylitol is a sugar-free sweetener. It's wonderful. It's made from birch bark, birch wood. It's natural, it's healthy, and it won't make you fat. Let's go ahead and put our xylitol in there. That's 1/2 cup of sweetener. Next, we want to add 2 teaspoons of cinnamon. We want to add 1 teaspoon of cloves. Next comes the allspice, 1 teaspoon. And now ground ginger. We have 1/2 teaspoon. Let's fire this up and process it. Now we're going to take a well-greased pie pan. Now, notice we don't have a crust. That's where all the sugar comes from and carbohydrates come from in pumpkin pie. In many pies, it's in the crust. So this is going to be a crustless pie. So we'll take a well-greased pie pan. We've already preheated our oven to 425 degrees. And we're just going to pour this wonderful mixture right inside of this pie pan. I wish you could smell it. It smells absolutely beautiful. So we have a preheated 425-degree oven, and we're going to put our pie in for the first 15 minutes at 425. And then we're going to drop the heat down to 350 and cook it for up to another 60 minutes, or until a knife comes out clean. So I'll put this in the oven, and we'll come back in 60 minutes and we'll check it out. Welcome back. We've successfully done it. We've roasted pumpkin for a beautiful dish on our table. We've got pumpkin seeds, which taste like popcorn. We've got this terrific pumpkin pie. This is absolutely fabulous. I'll make some wonderful homemade whipped cream and I'll serve that as a dessert. Now, make sure you tune into our next segment where pumpkin's gonna keep coming at you. We're gonna do pumpkin bread and pumpkin cookies. So we'll see you again the Fat to Skinny way. Eat your pumpkin.